Hi, Vern. Welcome to Scotland. I'm her dad, John.
And I'm her mum, Jeanette. Come on in.
For the past 7 years, my daughter has been the host of GMTV's Entertainment Today. However, prior to going to university, she was a waitress.
Your tea, sir.
Thank you very much. Last year, she put her horse riding skills to really good use when she took part in one reality programme, Only Fools and Horses.
Thank you for visiting us, Vermin.
See you soon.
Bye.
Bye.
Here with the family is the Queen of Entertainment today, Jenni Falconer! Hi, Jenni.
Hello there, Vern.
Welcome to Family Fortune.
Thank you, we feel very welcome.
Please introduce me to your family.
OK, well, this is the main man, the head of the clan, my dad, John.
Hi, John.
Hello, Vernon.
This is my mum, Jeanette.
Hi, Jeanette.
Hi, Vernon.
Lovely French maid, I think.
This is my brother, who's flown over from South Africa for tonight, Scott.
Hi, Scott.
Hi, Vernon.
And his beautiful wife, my sister-in-law, Dominique.
Hi, Dominique.
Hi, Vernon.
All right, Jenni, it's all about charity. Which charity are you playing for?
Well, it's a really great, small, Glasgow-based charity called BC2000, which raises money for breast cancer. So tonight, that's what we want to raise money for.
Well, it's all down to you, Jenni. Good luck, the Falconer family! One down.
Let's talk about Jenni.
Oh, right.
Has she always been this attractive?
Yeah, I must admit, Vernon, when she was just a little nipper, she was a beauty.
He's my dad, remember that.
Yeah, no, she was absolutely gorgeous.
He's not lying, Jenni, because we've got a picture. Take a look at this. Oh, little princess. A little princess. Was she always a hit with the boys, John?
Yeah, she was. In fact, she always aspired to get on to Blind Date, and she achieved that quite a few years ago. And that was the start of her on television.
Well, we've got that very...
Oh, no, you are joking.
That fateful day.
No.
Beginning of your televisual career.
Right.
Surprise! Take a look at this!
You'd like your men to look like?
Well, I just have this way to describe a man. I like him to be a complete hornbucket.
Your blind date number 3. Come in, Donna from Maidstone.
So, you see, that was the start of the career. This is the end of the career.
Well, I'll tell you what, Jenni, you sure got one heck of a family-sized horn bucket.
I know. He was nice. He was a handful, but fun.
It's a little more information than we needed, but let's move on. All right, Jenni, your dad, John, got 140 points,
which means
you need 60 to get £10,000. Remember, we're still looking for the 5 top answers. Oh. Can ask you the same 5 questions, but this time I'm going to give you an extra 5 seconds, so you've got 20 seconds. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass, and we'll come to it at the end if we've got time. And if you give me an answer that your dad's already given me, you'll hear this noise, and I'll ask you for another answer.
Okay.
Good luck, Jenni. Time starts when I've finished the first question. Let's remind the viewers at home of John's answers, and let's have 20 seconds on the clock.
Okay.
Good luck, Jenni. Name something you put on a bed.
A duvet.
Another answer.
Pillow.
Name an animal with horns.
A bull.
Name a popular sandwich filling.
Ham. Cheese.
Name a game you might play in the pub.
Darts.
Name an article of clothing that's made of leather.
A jacket.
Another answer.
Trousers.
Well done.
Well, at least you got some answers, don't you? Well, that's what's important.
That's what's really important. Remember, we need 60 to get to 200, and we're still looking for the top 5 answers. Wish you all the very best of luck. Let's turn around. Let's take a look at the board. Those are your dad's answers. Great score, 140.
It's really good.
Name something you might put on a bed. You said pillow. Our survey said 28. Well done, 168. We need 32 for 10 grand. Was cover the top answer? Yes, well done. Good going. Name an animal with horns. You said
Bull. Our survey said 27. Well done, 195. You only need 5 points for £10,000 and 200 points. Was bull the top answer? Yes, well done. Two out of two. You need 5 points for £10,000. Name a popular sandwich filling. You said cheese. Our survey said 5 points or more. Yes! Well done, Jenni. 224, which means we banked the £10,000. But was cheese the top answer? Yes, well done. Three out of three. Name a game you might play in the pub. You said darts. Our survey said 31. 255. If that doesn't matter anymore, we're looking for the top answers. Was darts the top answer? Yes. Well done, Jenni. The board, to be honest with you, is looking pretty darn good. Last question, name an article of clothing that's made of leather. First off, you said jacket, your dad had already said that. Then you said trousers. Our survey said 8. Now, that doesn't matter, because your dad said jacket, and it was worth 44. We've got 4 top answers. Is jacket the 5th final missing top answer? For £30,000.
£30,000
for your charity, but you've won that fantastic cruise. Well done, John and Jeanette. And you've been a great, great family. Give them a big round of applause, the Falconers! They're going to win with £30,000 for their charity. Let's see if our families can do it next week when we play more Family Fortunes. Good night!